Hi everyone, my name is Itay. I am an Israeli tour guide and travel consultant, and in the past I guided more than 30 Birthright trips. So should you go on Birthright? I mean, to go on a free gift-given trip to the other side of the world, to one of the most exciting places on the planet, 10 days, fully guided tour, hotels, everything provided, where you, as an eligible participant of Birthright, has Jewish connection to the place, personal connection, you're going to make experiences that you're going to cherish for your whole life. Of course you should come, there is no question about it. But in order to make your decision deeper and with more information, I'm going to tell you some things that I believe will be very helpful for you. First of all, Birthright is very, very intense. It's not a laid-back trip. In 10 days you are going to do what a normal person would do in maybe 2 weeks or more of traveling. The days are very long. They start relatively early, they end late. You meet in the evening with your group to different activities. If you want a vacation, go to Hawaii. Birthright is something a little different. Birthright has restrictions. On Birthright, you are restricted to a certain guideline list that every Birthright group has to work according to. For example, you cannot leave the hotel during the night to do whatever you want. You need to stay with the group. The alcohol policy is very, very strict. If you're after that extra drop of booze and you want to get completely, you know, you won't believe how many participants were sent home in the middle of the trip because they got completely drunk. It's not worth it. Third, Birthright is emotional. You go through experiences with a group of people that you might know or don't know before the trip. And as things are, you start to open up. You share things, it's touching you. You're in another country with people your age from your country and from Israel. It's strong. My suggestion is come with an openness and willingness to really immerse yourself in the experience. You're going to do it just once in your lifetime. A side note to this one. You can sign up to a group from your campus or town or to a group where people are coming from all over the States or any other country you are from. I noticed that sometimes if you're with people from your campus, you might feel, you know, I might say this, but then people will think about me, whatever they will think about me, and you start to close up and you don't really share, you don't really open up, you remain blocked, and it really hurts your own experience. So whether you should go with people from where you're coming from your campus, from your town, or maybe you should go to a tour with people from all over the States or other countries, it's really something you should consider yourself and think what will be better for you. The big advantage with going with people from your hometown is that after you come back, of course, you keep in touch, you go together to your Hillel center or whatever, and it's not just those 10 days of the group, you continue afterwards. So you can think about what is most appropriate for you. Fourth, Birthright will challenge you. For most people, spending 10 days with 50 people on a bus, sharing your room with people you might not know from before the trip, waking up at 4 a.m. to climb Masada, dipping in the Dead Sea when it's 100 degrees Fahrenheit outside, staying in a Bedouin tent, dancing with 500 people in the Western Wall on Friday night, those things might be slightly out of your comfort zone. So magic happens outside of the comfort zone. You know, you get the point. At some point or another, it's going to catch you a little. Okay, so you chose to go for it. Well done. A few advices about how to make better decisions getting to the tour. First, who is your trip organizer? Birthright is not actually running the trips. There are different traveling agencies in Israel, touring companies, that are organizing and running the trips themselves for Birthright. Each one of those tour organizers has its own unique qualities, its own benefits, its own way of doing things. And before choosing to sign up for a certain trip, it's a good idea to investigate a little bit and see what are the qualities of each organizer, what are you looking for, something maybe a bit more orthodox, a bit more liberal, you know, and try to find the best organizer for you. So I will give an example, not to leave it too vague. On every Birthright tour, there are 7 to 8 Israelis that will join the tour to 5 to 10 days. On most tours, they will join to only 5 days, half of the tour, but on some, they will join to the entire length of the tour. This is wonderful because they are your window to the Israeli society. You get to know them much better and you become friends with them and you stay in touch even after the tour. So you can look up for those tours that have the Israelis for the entire length of the tour. There are also themed tours, for example, a Birthright for photographers, Birthright for foodies, culinary, Birthright for scuba divers. There are lots and lots of them now. Next, extend. Are you a busy lawyer from Manhattan that has to be back to work the day after the group ends? If not, extend your stay. There is so much to do here. Squeeze the lemon a little bit. Man, I mean, if Israelis would get a free ticket to the other side of the world, the quickest one of them will be back maybe after 2 months. So take a few days extra, experience Israel on your own, outside of the Birthright bubble, and with no restrictions of what you can do during the nights. Third, YOLO. You're going to do a Birthright tour just once in your life. Make the best out of it. Open up, share your experiences. Don't hold back. Even if you're going to be in Israel afterwards or you've been here before, it's going to be different. Not better or worse, but different. Birthright is a unique experience that you do just this one time. Make the best out of it. If you like this video or you have any questions or thought, please write it in the comments below and subscribe to my channel. And if you're thinking about coming to Israel on a private tour, feel free to consult with me on any aspects of your tour. You can find my contact details in the description of the video below. Thank you and a beautiful day.